For today's video, I'm going to show you how you can get a bunch of legendaries in Cyberpunk 2077. And I'm going to show you 20 of them, which is a lot. So let's go ahead and jump into it. The first one we're going to take a look at are the legendary Manus Blades. In order to get these, you're going to have to open up a chest located near a Cyber Psycho. But you don't have to kill him, just run up to the chest and take it. A couple things I should point out is that in order to equip the Manus Blades, you will have to go to the nearest Ripper Dock. I thought I got scammed when I looked in my inventory, but you will see them available for free when you go to the Ripper Dock. And same thing is true with the legendary Mono Wire, which is what we're looking at now. In order to equip it, you will have to go to a Ripper Dock. And both of those cost like 100,000 eddies, so make sure you pick up these free ones, that way you don't have to spend your money on them. Speaking of which, I'm going to try to show at least one legendary item of each type, so we'll have some shirts, pants, hats, glasses, jackets. Obviously, we already got cyberware, as well as a legendary schematic and legendary weapon. So this one we're looking at right here is actually two, and these are the only ones that have a prerequisite. And basically, you just want to go to the end of the street right here. And in order to get these, you're going to have to first complete the Ghost Town quest. Once you complete that, you'll have to come to this area in between 11 p.m. and midnight. And once you get here at that time, you're going to want to go into this cave. Just go in the direction that I did. And eventually you'll come up to this crate that has a legendary car inside of it. And I've tested this car out. I believe the fastest it goes to is 210 miles per hour. And this car is expensive if you were to try to buy it from a fixer. So as soon as you complete that Ghost Town mission, make sure you come get this car, because it's one of the best cars in the game. And like I said, there's actually two items that are in this location. There's also a legendary shirt that didn't really come with a whole lot of armor, but obviously you can upgrade your items in Cyberpunk 2077. But that's how you get the supercar and a legendary t-shirt. We also got a legendary cyberware mod, and this one's called Ren 3U. And I believe it's gonna be good when it comes to gorilla arms. Next up, we got a pair of legendary pants. And the only thing I wanted to point out with this one is that there were a couple of cops nearby, but you should be able to pick up the pants without them noticing. Now, one tip I wanted to point out when you're getting these legendaries is that you can reroll the perks you have on them. And the way you do that is by saving the game before you pick them up, save the game, and then load that game, which is what I did for these pants because I wanted more mod slots. And then if you don't like what you see, just load the game again and repeat the process until you get the perks that you want on your legendary. So like I said, with these pants, I was trying to get as many mod slots as I could, and I tried for about an hour, but the most I could get were three, at least when it comes to the pants. So that was another tip I thought you should know before you start running around getting these legendaries. Now this next one we're looking at are another pair of legendary pants. And these were sort of located in a weird area, so I'm gonna go ahead and show how to get there as well as the location on the map, because I think it would be harder for y'all to find it if I didn't actually show how to get to it. So yeah, we're just gonna be doing some parkour for this one. Anyways, for those of you who are playing Cyberpunk, let me know where you're currently at. I believe right now I'm at the beginning of Act 2, so I still got quite a few ways to go before I finish. I've mainly just been focusing on the side missions at the moment, but let me know where you guys are at, and feel free to join our Discord. I'll leave a link to it in the description if you like somebody to talk to. But yeah, here are the pants that we got after parkour. Next up, we're going to take a look at a schematic that I found, and there's the location for it. And this place may look familiar for you. Once you come down here to the afterlife, instead of going the way you normally do, you want to go to the right, and you're going to want to go into this elevator and then go up to the roof. And this is sort of another one that's a little difficult to get to. Well, not too difficult, but once you get to the roof, you're going to want to follow in the same path that I do and then try to get on top of the barbed wire. And it may bounce you off a couple of times, and it'll also take away a little health, but just try to get on top of the barbed wire and then walk over to this corner, and you should get a schematic for a legendary weapon. And I haven't crafted this one out, so I don't know exactly if it's good or not, but that's how you get it. Next up, we're going to take a look at a legendary jacket that you can get. Actually, there's two jackets you can get from this location. This first one had 4 mod slots, which is the most I've seen on any legendary that I've gotten up to this point. I'm not sure if you can get more mod slots than that, but we got 4 on the first one, and we only had 2 mod slots on the second one. But the second one did have more armor. And I didn't try re-rolling these because I was happy that we had one with 4 slots. Next up, we got another pair of pants. And there's where it's located on the map. Once you get here, you will have to drive into the desert for a little bit until you come up to this little parking area. And once you get here, you'll see another dead body laying on the ground. All you have to do is just walk up to him. And as you can tell, he has some legendary pants for us. And these only had 2 mod slots, but again, you should be able to get up to 3 mod slots when it comes to all of the pants. Next up, we have another jacket, and it's going to be located towards the northern part of the map, next to these 2 circle tower things. And once you get to this location, you're just going to want to drive to where I do. Hop out. We had to run up this ramp, and there's another dead body. And this one has a legendary jacket. Now, the next legendary we're gonna take a look at are some more legendary pants. And this one's located next to the building that has the 12 on it. And I'm gonna go ahead and run all the way up there to show you where it's at. Anyways, believe it or not, there are a bunch of legendaries that I didn't show. I don't know how many legendaries are currently available, but I would say we're not even halfway, so if y'all would like me to show the remaining free legendaries that you can pick up, then let me know in the comments below. But yeah, here's another location where you can find some legendary pants. All right, so the one we're currently looking at right now are a pair of legendary glasses. And this one's sort of located in an alley, and it's not really too difficult to get to, but I did want to show how to get there from the main street, just so nobody gets lost. But yeah, you can have up to 3 mod slots on the glasses. I rerolled those a few times. This next legendary we're gonna take a look at are boots. And this one wasn't too hard to find either. All you have to do is just try to get next to this little drop box. And then once you're there, follow the path that I take to the elevator. And once you get to the elevator, you're gonna have to go to the 3rd floor because I believe there's a couple options. Yeah, just go to the 3rd floor. And then once you get to the 3rd floor, bust the left and keep walking towards the left, and you should see another box that has some legendary boots in them. Now, if you don't like those boots, I have another area where you can find 2 legendary boots. And all you're going to do is just come down to the end of this street. You should see a police car at the end of the street, and you're going to want to walk up the stairs that are next to the police car. Once you get up to the stairs, you're going to have to walk up some more stairs and then climb up a ladder. And once you get up there, you'll see some more dead bodies that have legendary boots. And I believe the most mod slots I could get on these were 3. Not sure if you can get more, but the most I could get were 3. But yeah, that's a good spot where you can find up to 2 legendary boots. So this next one we're going to take a look at is a legendary hat. And for this one, you're sort of going to have to climb your way up there. I'm going to show you the route that I took to get there. It wasn't really too difficult though. But yeah, you will have to climb a little bit in order to get to this hat. Another thing I should point out while we're taking a look at these is that you may not want to pick up all these legendaries because they're going to be scaled with your current level. So you may just want to pick up some legendaries now and then save the rest of the legendaries for when you reach the end game. That way you won't have to level those all the way up and waste materials. Now, this next one is one I would recommend you get as soon as you can because this gun is amazing, people. You will have to go into this little Arasaka base in order to get it, but I was able to get it without, you know, having to kill anybody. Just as soon as you enter, go all the way towards the end, and you're gonna see this trailer on the right. One thing I should mention is that there will be a proximity bomb in there that you're going to want to look out for. I didn't know it was in there when I went. I sort of had to learn the hard way. But there will be a proximity bomb you can destroy before you hop in there. And there is the legendary weapon. And I haven't tried all the weapons, but this one's good, people. You make sure you go get it. And the 20th legendary we're going to look at for this one is a legendary jacket. So like I said earlier, there are a lot more legendaries that you can get. If y'all would like us to do a part two, then be sure to drop a like. And if you're new to the channel, feel free to subscribe. Anyways, I hope y'all found the video useful, and thanks for watching.